following program is brought to you in living color.
Y'all ready for this?
Here we come.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hell yeah, yo.
Little bit of heaven, 94.7.
Morning, everybody. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning here at chaoticradio.com. My name is Roy Brewster. This is...
I am Jimmy Shaw, and we are joined, as always, by the lovely and talented...
Donna Main. Good morning, everybody.
I just love watching Roy's pre-show rituals.
I was wondering what was happening there. I thought maybe he was putting in his teeth or something at one point.
He had that head down. He was like...
And then praying.
Do a good show.
Some kind of ritual there. Yeah.
Like three seconds before we went on, he dropped his head right to the laptop. We're like... I can't reach the buttons from here, buddy. You're going to have to...
I was stretching up my back.
Micro stretches there. Yeah?
Yeah.
Keeping it limber.
Yeah, keeping it limber.
All that partying you did yesterday.
Oh, yeah. me and what do you call that thing? Carpet cleaner.
Yeah.
Had a date.
Oh.
What was that jingle? Rug doctor.
Steaming mad at dirt.
Oh, exactly.
Yeah. Steaming.
That'll be our show tagline from now on. Well. We're steaming mad at dirt.
Woo!
Yeah.
How was everybody's Memorial Day Monday?
Hooped it up a little bit. Okay,
you and Rob go Mai Tai part two?
No. I have to give a shout out to Rob this morning because we did do a little bit of the barbecuing yesterday.
Attaboy.
It's the law. You have
with
to.
With some of my family. And this was the best line of the day.
Oh.
I have to give it to Rob. My brother-in-law got some food on his plate, and immediately I zeroed in and I said, "There's a hair in your food."
Oh, no.
And I am usually the one who gets the hair in the food. And so Rob immediately said, "She could see a hair from outer space." So that was... See,
a hair detector and also a buzzkill right there.
Right.
So did he work around the hair?
That was the best line of the day.
Did he work around the hair or figured it's family hair? Okay.
I think it was his own hair, but he removed it. But yeah, I'm usually...
But he didn't give up on the plate.
No, absolutely not. No, well, he's the cook, actually.
There you go. You're a warrior. I know the food's good.
The barbecuer and the chef. So.
And we're family. That's my DNA.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah, this was all family and friends, but...
DNA adjacent.
But that was what was so funny, is usually I'm the one who gets the hair, and I can see it from...
And what do you do? Do you, like,
from
bail?
Outer space.
Do you bail on the plate when you see the hair?
It depends.
She doesn't want to admit it.
It depends, yeah.
It depends on the...
maybe the source of the hair.
Hey, yeah, that's what I was looking
the
for.
The source and also the Mai Tai scale.
Well,
is like,
that probably can work into the equation. Yeah,
it's just food with built-in floss.
Exactly.
Sort of.
So gross.
If it's a restaurant and you know it's not yours.
Unless it's like a magic trick hair where you just keep going and going.
Just keep pulling it out.
Well, this one, we brought the family, did we?
Yeah.
Ta-da. Yep. And then you got to break it down. Well, I know it's not a nose hair. It's too long.
Oh, good Lord.
Good Lord, we got grosser.
Had my dog there, too. It was not hers. Wasn't hers.
Yeah, your dog got hammered taking selfies all day.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's...
If you, Mama, cut me. Dog's doing duck lips, cutting her out of every picture.
Yep, pretty much.
How dare you mock me on the radio.
I got something to go so far with this.
I shot Roy down pretty good right on that one there.
I'm not going to, because it's kind of early.
Is it kind of early?
Yeah, it is early.
Yeah, for me to take.
What the heck?
That's why we're here. We already got people in their car going, yeah, I thought I saw a hare, but they were in their drunken stupor. So it's like an honor badge, really.
It wasn't a hare. It was, never mind. I don't even,
I'm
not going to do it. Not going to do it.
What can you do beyond
it? No, it's just a thought I have sometimes. And sometimes my thoughts don't need to be public.
Be very afraid. Very afraid. It is Tuesday morning. You guys are all back to work. You are on those lovely highways we call.
Treacherous, sharp-clawed little peacock.
She was from a fever for which I'll never recover. I can teach you to do the deep impressions right
the
there.
The food of the gods.
You are the food of the gods, and I must have you. That's what you should have done at the barbecue. You are the food of the gods.
Oh, yes. Yeah,
and I must have you.
And then I will have all of you.
And then pull the hair out. And now for my next trick. 10 foot long strand of hair in your food. That is so disgusting. Hit the road, guys. You are late to work. It is chaotic radio
time. It's a
great
way to start.
Chaotic radio time.
What'd you have for breakfast?
Nothing now.
I'm so sorry.
Chaotic radio time is 7:08. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning with Donna Main. Get your butts going. We're coming back. It's abundant. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning. Chaoticradio.com. Don't be shy. Give us a call. 360-8330. If you got a live traffic report for us.
Yeah.
Give us a call. That'll get you a Kudos pizza. Yeah. On us. On us.
On Kudos, kind of.
Well, on Kudos, kind of. But from us. With love.
We're the conduit.
We're the conduit between the liaison. Of your pizza.
Liaison.
Of your pizza from Kudos Pizzeria.
Pizza. Pizza liaison.
We probably should get down to the basics here because yesterday was nothing. A little traffic, a little weather, see what's going on there. I think
well, we had weather yesterday, but we didn't have any weather.
It did warm up a little bit here, but we'll do a little weather catch up with Donna Main.
Did you see that?
I was like rapping and everything.
Here we are, guys, in Rancho Cucamonga this morning. Mostly cloudy, 58 degrees. The high today will be 83. It's going to warm up substantially.
But still much lower than expected.
Is it much lower than expected?
I don't know.
This is the end of May.
And we're in 80s.
May gray.
Yeah.
May gray.
June gloom, all that good. All those nice rhymes.
Oh, wait a minute. We got more. Okay, never mind.
Okay. Cut and Shoot, Texas, our home office. Oh, it's beautiful there right now. It is sunny, 84 degrees, and the high will be 93.
Couldn't shoot.
Wow, so get out those bikinis, guys.
I got mine ready.
Those cut and shoot bikinis.
Yes, cut and shoot bikinis. All right, I'm looking for our friends in Langford, South Dakota, and it is now 76 degrees, partly cloudy. That's lovely, actually. It might be a little humid. High today, 86 degrees in Langford.
Comfy.
That's pretty good.
I'm calling that comfy, yes.
And not far away from us, in the City of the Angels, Los Angeles, it is now 62 degrees and cloudy. Ugh. And the high will only be 73.
Well, that's kind of us right now, too. We are clouded up right now.
But we will get warmer today.
It warmed up yesterday. It did, as promised.
Yeah, downtown LA is not going to get that warm. But that's the weather for today, guys.
Excellent, excellent. Ready, Roy, you ready to kill everyone's buzz on this traffic?
All right.
All right. we're going to fire up the Chaotic Radio Kudos Pizzeria traffic helicopter with Commander Roy.
Like that. 71 Freeway West southbound. You're not going west on the 71, or you caused the accident. 71 southbound. Start slowing at Euclid Avenue. Speeds are down to 11. 91 westbound from the 15 all the way to the 71. Get your coffee and get a donut. Down to 9 miles an hour there. 210 westbound just past the 15. Looks like speeds are starting to slow at Carnelian. Backed up all the way. You're looking about 18, 20 miles an hour all the way to the 15. And just reported, 10 freeway eastbound. Sig alert at Monta Vista. Serious crash.
Oh, yeah.
We're down to 7 miles an hour from Indian Hill all the way back to the 71. And we'll give you one more. 210 freeway just west of the 57. Speeds are down to 14 miles an hour. No apparent reason, just because people are hitting a little corner.
Because it's Tuesday.
That little curve in the road. It's amazing what makes a traffic jam these days.
Oh, it's amazing what can happen to that little curve, too.
Yeah.
Oh.
There's a guardrail in the middle. You should all dodge.
Or take it from us. You can't blow through it. It's not an escape route.
No, we'll do one more. 710 southbound. That's the 60 westbound at the 710 southbound. Crash moved to the right shoulder. Speeds are down to 12 miles an hour. And that is your first update from the Kudos Pizzeria, Roy and Jimmy, and the Morning Traffic Copter.
That was a mouth. You did great.
Yeah, that was.
I like that. I like that very much.
There was a lot going on there.
A lot going on. That's pretty good. A big shout out to everyone watching our Facebook Live pre-show video. Richard Barba, my sister-in-law, Maricela, Roy Brewster. He tuned in again. That guy, what a fan.
Really?
Yeah, always in there. That guy's always in there.
Yeah.
My mom, Daniel Blackburn, i.e. David Phillips. And a plethora of more. He even says one more comment. I don't want to leave someone out. Ariana, greetings. We got greetings this morning.
Greetings.
How civilized that is.
Yes. Pip, pip, cheerio.
Pip, pip, civilized, royal stiffy,
so
and all that.
I can't even say that. It's so unbecoming of me.
What's that, royal stiffy?
Yeah.
Why can't you say that?
I'm so straight-laced.
Well, of course, we're trying to...
Wait a minute.
This face might have been better than the Tom Jones face yesterday. She's like, hang on.
I rather enjoy saying royal stiffy.
It's just
fun.
I don't like to cross that line, ever.
Ever?
Mm-mm. Hmm.
Well, so,
Is it time for a cornhole update? I don't know.
It's not like New Year's Eve and this is a resolution, dude. There, let's give you a little more. Let the wind hit you in the face a little bit. There you go.
Land that thing. We're out of gas.
Give you a little room.
Jesus.
Okay, let's remind Roy of our mission statement here at Roy and Jimmy in the Morning right here.
Oh, yes.
It's our job to teach you all the ins and outs of cornhole.
See, our mission statement right there.
I like that.
We need to be reminded of that once in a while. Yes,
needed. We can actually
recommit.
Yes, we refocus our energies on this enterprise.
Uh oh,
he said. Oh,
my cornhole thing is gone.
that's some plastic surgery right there.
Yeah,
I went for a more aerodynamic.
Yes.
Roy was wondering if his taint could be any bigger, that area.
We can go back to the royal stiffy if we need to.
Right. He just shut down, dude. So my cornhole's gone. That's done.
Be all backed up.
It sounded so sad.
And he's just like,
There it is. Top players.
All right.
Jordan Camba. Good cornholer right there. Cody Henderson from Ohio. 3 is Adam Hissner. 4, James Baldwin. I love James Baldwin. What do you got? I got a Baldwin.
Baldwin's coming up.
Alan Rockwell, number 5. Terry Birchfield, number 6. Christine. I'm glad I reread this. Papk. And I thought it said pack pipe. Pack is number 7.
A girl. Wow.
Good at cornhole.
Wow, we've already integrated.
8, Chris Novi. 9, Ashton Spees. And 10, Tanner Halbert are the top 10 cornhole players of the United States.
Wow.
As of now.
Wasn't there somebody named Johnson a couple weeks ago?
The Johnsonville Sausage Tournament was in Las Vegas.
Yes, that's right.
Which
that's
is probably
right.
the best sponsor of the cornhole.
Let's go to the best names. Number 13 is Michael Dingus.
Oh.
Born to play. Sense.
Yeah.
And number 15, Perfect. Chucky Love.
Oh, jeez. Oh.
Chucky Love knows Chucky how to Love. Play the cornhole.
So he gave up his porn career.
Chucky Love.
Little Chucko.
Went from porn to corn, something like that.
Cinderella story.
Chucky Love.
Cinderella story.
Chucky Love.
Porn to, from porn to corn.
Porn to corn.
The Las Vegas Invitational. Wow.
I will not partake in this. This conversation is beneath me.
This cornhole is beneath me. And so is the sun. I'm teaching Roy. I'm going to teach Roy how to be deep.
Oh,
that way you can pull out the whole Yul Brynner look.
Right, right.
And the deep. The deep.
Sharp claw.
I still like, instead of Mr. Clean, I was Mr. Tidy.
Mr. Tidy. It's all right.
Kind of tidy.
It's all right.
Yeah.
But then you jumped on it, like you said. You did the rug doctor bit because you had the whole, we set the tone with Mr. Clean here.
Yes.
Got home. He's standing true. There, hands on true. His hips. Put an earring back in.
That's right. You got into character yesterday with the earring back in. The rug cleaning.
This place is a dump. I shall clean you, my peacock.
Actually, I was out driving my Uber, and Dawn says, I need some help. That's how it happens.
She's like halfway up the stairs with five pieces of machinery.
Well, here's
tangled in the hoses.
Here's the thing is, like, you rent one of those, and you buy all the
accoutrement,
the cleaner.
Yes.
I mean, so you rent it, it's like $25 or something.
Yeah.
And then you can buy the cleaner. You're like, you're $50 in.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay? And you know, in our household, a little tight because this lazy ass ain't working right now. Still, hey, if you need something done, let me know. So.
Carpet cleaning.
Yeah.
No, not that.
Cleaning.
Oh, actually, yeah, because then I'm like, we're going to spend that much. So I start looking on OfferUp. I said, let's just buy our own. Probably the same price.
Oh, I thought you were going to say, let's just hire somebody to do it.
Let's just buy our own machine.
Yeah.
So I'm looking
you're thinking
around,
long
looking,
term.
Right. It's like, so I'm looking around. I found a place. I can't remember the name of it. They don't pay us, so I'm not going to tell you. But it's in Chino. It's an outlet. Bought a brand new Bissell, 2x heated, blah, 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 whatever. Came with 6 things of solution. The attachments for your couches and all that stuff.
Yeah.
$60.
Wow.
Brand new in the box. This thing is the bomb. It works so good.
Yeah.
And I'm like, we just spent and bought it and have it in the house forever instead of renting and going again. So now, you know, if I ever should piss myself on a floor, we have a way to clean it up immediately.
If it does occur.
I'm getting old. You talked about how gas does that. It just falls out.
You just,
sometimes it just, you just got to tinkle.
You're thinking long term.
Yeah.
Short investment. So you went $10 over budget, but you have it forever now.
Yeah.
Forever.
It pays for itself.
So I did 3 bedrooms, upstairs hallway, the downstairs formal dining room, and then now I'll do the living room today, the area rug, and Kylie's closet. That'll be good.
And that's great, because when you're in the mood, it's right there.
Oh, I'm not in the mood. What happened?
You don't have to go out and get it.
No, what happened?
You wake up and go, you know what?
I'm in the mood.
I'm in the mood for this. Let's do this.
To be somewhat tidy today.
I'm not in the mood. A little sore.
Yeah.
Little back spasming, hurting back business. And you were saying, we're talking about it.
Yes.
You were saying, like, it's funny now, like, when you watch the dog or something, you got to bend around all the time.
Just like bending over, it's like you're not, your body's reminding you you're not 21 anymore.
And it's not quite a full bend or squat. It's that in-between one that is the killer.
Yeah.
So halfway washing the dog and you stand up and like,
And those muscles are like, hey, remember me?
We don't do that anymore.
Yeah.
I don't know what you're trying to prove, mister.
Well, you guys are in shape, because me, it's kind of anything that involves movement.
do not be fooled by our exterior right here.
Yeah.
I am nursing this knee right now.
We like to think we're, 29.
Yeah, I got to be a big boy. I got my physical therapy today, so I can't, whine too much, but I have to let them know where it's sore, because, why I'm there.
They give you a lollipop? Or a sticker?
I hope so. I really would like one at the end there. I'll give it to Roy, right?
Yeah,
I'll
you need the lollipop.
Jacket. Look at him. I'll just co-jack it right over to
bring
him.
In the lollipops.
Well, I need sugar-free ones, probably.
Yeah.
Because, keto stuff.
Oh.
Yeah, so, okay.
Keto-free.
Is it
pro-keto? What are we looking
at? It's pro-keto.
Is keto good, or are you not doing keto? I don't understand the terminology. What's keto?
The keto is when you, because you're going into, you're eating just fats and proteins. So then you're going to start feeding off yourself without the carbs to lose the weight, basically.
You're going
to
eat yourself.
Yeah. You're going to eat yourself.
You mean like the fly?
No, a little different.
What does keto stand for? Does it,
ketosis.
Ketosis. Ketosis.
Ketosis is when your body starts going into that state.
Ketoing out.
And then you piss on these little sticks, tells you you're in ketosis.
Yeah, pee on things?
That's why I need the vacuum.
You're supposed to be using your reserves rather than
storing
it, and you're not eating carbs. So you're,
That sounds very scientific.
It's supposed to be. It might kill me, but I'll be thinner. You won't have to buy a big casket.
We're trying to, again, we're saving on the long term right here.
He's always looking at the big picture,
the big
isn't
picture
he?
Here.
Yeah.
If I could save $10 on this casket, that'd be my legacy right there.
Right. So if I get a sucker, it needs to be sugar-free.
Sugar-free. No, it's just the no carbs. Yeah,
and lollipops are.
I should
form a carb.
Well, because it's got sugar.
Sugar is the carb.
Sugar's the carb. Sugar and pasta.
I am gonna have a hard time once my doctor finally says, "Dude, you need to cut back on some shit." I'm so confused right here. So what do I don't eat?
No, yeah, but you probably would just eat whatever you want.
I do.
You do. We know.
You follow me on Instagram. I am posting and bragging and showing
pictures
off.
Oh my God.
Yeah, and that's for
it's the food of the gods.
And that's for everybody. That's me sharing. All the locals go out and eat all this stuff.
Yeah.
Or at least say you did.
But most people can't eat what you eat without it showing
Ill
up.
Effects.
Elsewhere.
Well, I'm wondering what's going
to... I just get my little belly punch, and it's immediate too. When I'm full, my belly is out.
Well, I'm wondering what's going to happen if you're because you got a cat knee too.
Yeah.
And you're not doing that 37 miles of walking a day.
That's how it starts, cat knee.
True. Yeah. Once the cat knee starts, then it's porn to corn.
Yeah.
Cat knee, the fat belly.
And then it's all beneath you.
And then it's all beneath me. And so is his daughter.
A stiffy in the neck. A stiffy.
At our age, we get the stiffies in all the wrong places.
Right?
And they last way longer.
Talk about.
The switch off is brutal.
The irony. The irony of it all.
Man, I got a stiffy in my neck for weeks.
Hey, baby, I am stiff. What, like 5 days now? What? My back hurts.
It's misplaced longevity is what it is.
As you limp across the room. I am limping for the wrong reasons here, baby. Put this shit in a bottle, we'll be all set.
Put my neck in a bottle. That'd be a wide mouth bottle.
Yeah.
You gotta find my neck first.
Don't stare me right in the eyes when you say shit like that. It's like right.
I saw that moment between the two of you.
I just like back off.
I couldn't stare at Donna when I said it.
That'd be weird.
I always have a problem. I have no idea when women are hitting on me or flirting with me. But man, I'll tell you, homosexual, I am on it. I'm like, what is this, dude? I knew you all these years.
What did you just call me?
I didn't call you. I'm just saying when it's a man moment, I'm shook to the core. I'm just like.
I've had that problem with
I wasn't
though.
Sure if I was supposed to say, oh, fellas. or, oh, fellas.
Right.
Or, fellas.
It's all... I've had that problem with women where being in the customer service field, you know that when you talk to a woman, you have to look them in the eyes. Mm-hmm. And your eyes... And I make it a point. Because I'm not one that'll stare at a woman's chest when you're talking. I don't do that.
Hey, okay? My eyes are up here,
right.
Buddy.
But
hey,
I don't do
my
that.
My microphone is right here.
Yeah.
I see people do it.
Yeah.
If I'm another guy, and I see him dude, that just bothers me. So I go, I don't do it, but I think I go over the top so much that, like, if I'm talking to you, I'm like zoned, and I'm like, and just like, and I think that sometimes makes some women more uncomfortable.
Yeah, probably.
Because
it's
like
too intense.
Kind of intense. Like,
you may see him.
See, Donna? Like I'm afraid to look anywhere. That little mic thing right there.
Yeah, yeah.
Never.
Yeah, I get it.
But she's giving me the eyeballs back, and I'm scared.
You gave them to me, and I was out in 5 seconds. Like, what are you doing?
But I've actually had women when I talk to them like that, especially in a place of business, and you're really and you're professional, and you're just talking,
right?
And you're looking right at them, and you see them just kind of like, ooh, like zone out, like this is weird. And I'm like, what do you do?
Well, you
do what I do. You run off like Napoleon Dynamite.
You're supposed to make some eye contact, for sure. And I know I've had the experience with men and women where they're checking you out while they're talking to you, and that's super uncomfortable.
Right.
Like, if they're looking you up and down, even if it's a woman, like, looking at what I'm wearing or my shoes or what, you know, whatever, it's like... Yeah, my eyes are up here. Yeah,
hey, lady.
Yeah. Hey.
But if they're looking too much, does that bother you too?
Well, see, once you get aware of anything like that, then you're done.
Right.
Then your eyeballs are all over the place.
And like with women, you expect the next thing that comes out of their mouth is going to be some kind of a comment on, you know, oh, I like your earrings, or like, you know, some whatever it is.
Something to match the
checkout.
Yeah,
and you're like, what is it? What are they looking at? You know, when you're...
I got a booger? Yeah. Someone say something. Yeah. Say something.
Yes.
And break away.
And if it's somebody you know, what is it? Do I have something in my teeth?
Just tell me.
Just let me know.
Yeah.
No, he eyeballed me. You straight up. You.
Yeah. That was...
You handsome man, you.
That was quite a moment there.
Don't do it.
The treacherous little peacock.
That's how bad it is. I'm going to stare at Don instead of you. You're making me uncomfortable.
This peacock thing is affecting him. You were giving him lessons.
His magnetism
from
yesterday is just really showing here with his new look here.
Good thing I didn't wear the earring.
He's taking it on.
Right?
He's taking on the whole persona.
Exactly.
The Yul Brynner persona.
This is Roy with Roy and Jimmy in the morning.
We gotta start singing some songs from The King and I.
The King and I.
You know what's kind of bothers? Not bad, but I mean it's good, but it's not. Since I did this to my hair, so far now, Dawn's dad, Kylie, who lives in the house with us, obviously, Dawn's daughter, and Lindsay, her niece. None of them noticed my head was shaved.
Oh, no.
See, and I noticed right away, even with the hat on.
Right.
Yeah.
But I noticed, and I told Don, I said, no one even noticed. You think especially someone would be like, dude, what'd you do to your hair?
Yeah.
But no one noticed.
Start leaning in on conversations now since they didn't notice. So, how's it going?
And the quote from Don says,
a little reflection.
Is that how he put his head down? That's why.
Yeah.
She said, well. And I know what she meant, but the way she said it, or not the way she said it, it's not the way she said it, just because it was said. I know what she meant, but her comment was, well, it's not that much different.
It's true. It wasn't drastic. It's like if you took the goatee off and shaved the head, then it'd be like, whoa.
But it's like, wait a minute, I had hair, now I don't. That's not much different? That doesn't say a lot about the hair I have.
Like you said, that stubble you had... It was noticeable when you took it off. And like I said, you had a hat on yesterday and you came walking up. I'm like, holy shit, you took it off.
Yeah.
But everyone else with the full on.
But your face is the same. You didn't change the facial hair. So that's probably part of it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
When I shaved my goatee, Kylie was all over it. Oh, you look old.
And I got, when I did it, I looked like I was 18.
Right.
So I was like, okay.
She told me.
She told me, that's funny.
She told me, she said, you look like Pop.
I don't like that at all.
Oh, no.
No, I don't.
Isn't that funny? That's true. Facial hair on men. For some people, makes you look older. Some people makes you look younger.
It takes you all the other way. Well, it's probably because of all the white I have going on right there. So, oh, my God. You look like you're 10. 12. Yeah. That was my bit. It's Roy and Jimmy tomorrow. It's chaoticradio.com. Your time is 7:39. We're coming back.
Roy and Jimmy in the morning here on chaoticradio.com, brought to you by Kudos Pizzeria.
66 fresh ingredients.
How many fresh ingredients?
66 fresh ingredients.
13 quadrillion combinations.
One convenient location. That's some math right there.
Mind-boggling.
It is mind-boggling. That is Kudos Pizzeria, Rancho Cucamonga, Milliken and 4th, just due north.
We always.
Oh, that's me.
I thought it was me. I was looking at my thing.
I figured I'll put some music underlaying on this kudos thing.
There was somebody's stomach growling. Talking about pizza.
That's Kudos Pizzeria. Definitely check out their Facebook page. They have a weekly and daily specials, coupons, and most importantly, they have fresh, fast, and good for you food.
Delicious food, right?
I believe that's what the commercial says. I believe that's what we said in the commercial.
That's what we said.
It's not just lip service, baby. Go get a pizza. Or pasta, or more.
Oh, fellas.
That is a pretty quiet Tuesday for after a three-day weekend. I think everyone's kind of burnt out.
Let's get people fired up.
We need people fired up here. We got.
I thought you were turning into a pirate there for a second. I didn't know where that was going.
He's hanging on those last letters. You are a pirate.
I want to get people fired up. I think I know how.
Okay. What you got?
What gets people fired up? On our show,
what gets us fired up
things
is...
Things that piss us off.
Yeah. Stupid things. Stupid people. Traffic. Yeah.
Okay, stop.
And music. That's stop. That gets us fired
up
the other
way. That's the opposite. Yeah, it's a happy fired up.
Top 10 most annoying things in life.
Oh.
All right. Hang on.
It's right in Jimmy's wheelhouse.
I think I need to put my knee brace on my neck right now. Here we go.
Where's the blood pressure cuff?
No, you didn't. Here they come. I'm a finger snap. I'm going to be all over this thing. Yes, okay. Right. Get me pumped up. Let's go.
Top 10. What's do I sound Halloween?
Halloween?
No, hollow. Like hollow? Like something?
Something. Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit. I like it, though. It's a good effect right there.
Oh, you know what? I got Donna Too Hot. Oh, sorry. Got a little too high.
After Memorial Day.
It's not unusual.
Are we going into Tom Jones now?
I just did a little callback.
It's not unusual.
Because we're professional comedians also.
Yes.
Besides being on the radio.
Okay.
Top 10 things that piss you off. Number 10.
These bad
advertisements.
Yes.
And
not just your regular commercials on TV. Those don't really piss me off. The only thing that pisses me off about those is the volume. They were supposed to take care of that years ago.
Okay. There are some where the actual ad itself is just so freaking annoying.
Yeah.
Like the, you're killing me, Larry, that kind of thing. And then there's other ones that I can't explain why they just rub me the wrong way.
Yeah, it could be just those injury lawyers, mesothelioma. If you know somebody, you can get some money. I just start throwing things.
This is funny because I don't know if this is what Tony meant when he got in the chat room or not, but I think he came in right at the thing. He says, ! Top 10 things that piss you off. Is that what it was? That's hilarious if it is. So, top 10s. So it says, I hope someday they'll give it advertisements. They can put automatic skip button. Billy Mays here with an amazing product. Okay, number 10. Number 9, this drives me up a wall, and maybe I'm a little, spoiled is the word I'm looking for.
Okay.
A slow internet connection.
Oh. We are spoiled on that, yes.
Yeah.
This piece of shit. I probably shouldn't be cussing. We gotta get that national gig. I gotta knock the cussing down right there. Okay. But yeah, the internet's funny that way because we all had modems. And when we had the 14 the 14.4K was we were flying.
Well, I remember signing on to AOL.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And you'd go sign on. And then you'd go in, make yourself a sandwich.
You've got mail.
And you'd be away from it. You had to go do something else for a while, then come back. And then you'd hear, you got mail, then you can go check it out.
Yeah. Right.
But Or you download a picture. Wait.
Yeah, but you were excited because it was happening.
And you could see it.
And you're just hoping no one called you or you didn't move the phone wire that was in the modem.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So that's a little...
This is the sweet, innocent old days.
And then you go... And I love how when the internet's down, you just go and unplug everything.
Yeah.
You shake it because, even in this day and age, we still have to jiggle things. That's what I tell people. Still got to jiggle the wire, like the toilet handle. You still have to mechanically jiggle shit.
That's true.
The wire, the modem. Smacking around a little bit.
So, Tony was talking about that. All he said in the chat room was, that bitch.
Easy, Tony. Easy, buddy.
That's great. See, we got people fired up. Yeah. Number eight, Jimmy's going to have a problem with it.
Oh, okay.
Rap.
What kind of rap?
It just says rap.
R-A-P?
Mm-hmm. You like some rap sometimes.
You're talking about rap music?
Rap music.
Let's see.
Well, okay.
Let's see. Let's see if I can be credible with all this here. I don't really keep up with what's going on now as far as music goes. I think everything sounds the same. I think everyone's mad because they're supposed to sing mad.
Yeah.
But I don't get it. When it all became, let's say, mainstream, mm-hmm. they were fun. They had good hooks.
I liked a lot of the old school
stuff, early Dougie Fresh, stuff, Run DMC, Digital Underground. But now everybody wants to be a message. Everybody wants us to learn something.
What I don't like is all the ones that repeat over and over again.
Right.
Like, you know.
Yeah, no, I'm saying.
I won't
no
say
saying,
it all.
No
the B yeah. word, the, you know, the hose, the this is, the that's a constant. Yeah. And in this, you know, Me Too era.
Yeah.
That stuff is still popular, which is kind of
And it's kind of like what we were talking about.
Ironic.
We were talking about movies a couple weeks ago about the teen movies now. Mm-hmm. is like, you know, okay, you know, everyone's got to have their own era, their own generation. So I'd be curious to watch one of those movies and see what they're up to.
Yeah.
See what these kids are up to without sounding old. But, you know, my music was shit to my parents at the time.
That's true.
Sure,
and,
yeah,
you know, so
yeah.
it's all generational. I mean, and if you go back, you know, when people started listening to Bing Crosby, you're like, blasphemous.
Right,
oh my, you guys are dancing?
I mean,
you know, so.
How about Elvis?
Yeah,
I like music. You know, I like some current music too. It's not. I know I'm older, but I do like it for, you know, many decades of music, old and new.
Yeah,
and but I'm selective, really selective about the rap.
I'll take a moment.
The rap music.
Yeah, I don't have kids, but I'll take a moment like I have kids. Going, let me understand what's going on. So I work with a lot of youngins, so I can. Mm-hmm. I like popping them a pop culture reference that's current. They look at me like, what the hell. You don't know. I kind of know. I'll pretend to know.
Yeah. Kind of do.
I'll carry on a conversation 3-4 minutes. Yeah. You'll think I know everything. So,
yeah.
I'll say today's rap, I'm not into it, but I definitely like rap. There you go.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Well, Tony's in the chat room. We got him fired up. I told you it's going to fire somebody up.
Everything's an exclamation point, Tony.
Wow.
Tony Storm.
And he said, yes, rap, and wearing your friggin' pants below the hip.
Shoot and stab. I think that was named after you. Calm down, Tony.
You know what's funny? It kind of seems. It seems like that fad is going away a little bit. It's not as prevalent as it used to be.
What's
with
that?
Pants
the low
pants.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, the pants.
Yeah, in the fashion. Yeah, exactly.
It's not as prevalent, but there are degrees like. And
degrees,
actually,
yeah, that medium from plumber's crack to white boy
really
gangster look.
I don't like it when I can see like all of your chonies. You know, that's
the Keith Reza effect. I call it when me and Rosie Trans have
the
size.
I don't really need to see
full
all
on
of
white
it.
Ass before a show. He stood up and his pants were already low without a belt, so he set up to go up. He walked right out bare-ass. He didn't even know his pants were that far down. And his undergarments, too. Rosie Tran's husband looked at each other. You caught that, right? Okay, good. Not just me. Not just me.
Yeah.
And it's how is it? I fight that problem, but it's because...
Your pants?
Yeah, I got to keep them pulled up.
Right.
Yeah,
because you're a madman.
I went out the other day, and I forgot my belt. And I had a pair of shorts on. I go, damn. What's that? And what's that? My pants fall down if I wear shorts. Right?
Right.
So they'll fall down. But in the legs, they ride up.
You are a human phenomenon.
It's like my ass is eating.
You just, whatever exposes skin on Roy, it's going to happen. That's what you are.
All right.
You're
this,
a giver.
Wow.
But I won't say just rap music. I'll say all music, because right now I think everything sounds the same. Pop-wise and rap-wise. Whereas if we go back into like the 80s, everything was such a different genre, different kind of song. They're all one-hit wonders, but at least it was just different varieties. You know, write a song. Yeah. Write it down. Sing me a song. Don't just give me a hook from something I heard in the 70s and just be mad on top of it.
It's not working.
Yeah. That's better than Tommy the Sword. That guy, we saw an interview with Tommy the Sword on TV, and the way he does that old man sit, you know, he's leaning back like this, and his package was so compressed, it was this catcher's mitt of freaking man nonsense down there, and it was like, Tommy, calm yourself, put a shawl over you or something like that. All right, so rap. What was next?
Anyway,
this is making me mad right now because I'm trying to.
All
right,
yeah.
Are you trying to play something?
We went from the rap to the pants, hanging low.
The last time I was on stage, I opened up with a rap.
Well, like I said, I...
And the crowd went crazy. my mad skills.
So, yeah, I like some of like the old rap, hip-hop stuff that you can, you know, it's good for dancing and...
There you go, right? You want to... You need a little something?
It's going to lose its... It's going to lose its pop.
Uh-oh. Well,
but see, now you're in a suspense mode. Now we have to finish this.
We're in suspense. So that was... That was number eight.
Okay, ready?
1, 2, 3.
Pants on the ground, pants on the ground. Looking like a fool with your pants on the ground. With the gold in your mouth, hat turned sideways, pan hit the ground. Call yourself a cool cat, looking like a fool. Walking down the town with your pants on the ground. Giddy up. Hey, get your pants off the ground. Looking like a fool, walking, talking with your pants on the ground. Giddy up. Hey, get your pants off the ground. Looking like a fool with your pants on the ground. Go with the mouth.
That guy was freestyling.
Wow.
That guy was on Idol. Some old guy.
Yeah.
Made me laugh. Anyway, that was like a long road to hoe right there. Because I wanted to play it like under us as we were talking about it.
Right. Dang.
So that one lost its pop.
Well,
right.
We got it, though. We got
Roy,
it.
Don't be upset, Roy. It's okay.
Okay, so rap. We're done with rap.
Rap.
We're good.
Okay.
Number seven, I understand it, but yes, I'm sorry. It does bother me. Screaming babies.
I don't mind screaming babies because I think I understand shit happens with babies. They don't know anything.
Yeah, that was it. I understand it. But my deal is if it goes on too long,
well,
excuse yourself from the situation.
I think we need a little more information on this one. Because if you're... really makes me upset if it's in a movie theater.
Restaurant.
During a movie.
Right.
You know, you have the option of taking your child outside.
Exactly.
That was my thing.
And you shouldn't be bringing babies to movies anyway, in my opinion. But
right. Or you're in a restaurant and you know, babies, things happen. But, you know, definitely excuse yourself and do something about it. Or try to comfort the baby. Because
I mean, obviously, if you're on an airplane, you're not going to be able to take the kid outside. So you're
bring your headphones.
Going to have to deal with it for a while.
And that's something. I don't mind screaming babies. I got a problem with screaming kids.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, but they can kind of go in there. I don't know when the thing came up where you could sit at a restaurant and you allow your kid to run up and down our freaking place and do whatever they want.
Oh,
when did that happen?
That happens so much these days.
No,
I know.
It's
not
awful.
Not in our day.
No. We got our ass whipped.
I'm gonna
go outside and get a come to Jesus and then we come back.
I'm gonna rent my dad out to these people just because he set the bar. He didn't beat the shit out of us, but man, he had a force. He still has it. He still got this formidable presence. I am probably a foot and a half taller than him.
Yeah.
And he gives me a look like Roy did, and I'm done. I'm like, what do you need, Daddy?
We were so happy to be out. We just wouldn't behave that way.
We're just happy they weren't mad at us.
And if we got a little too riled up, I mean, my dad just had this deep voice.
Yeah.
And you just had, all he had to do was say something to you, and you knew.
Yeah, my dad had keywords. If we all had to calm down or shut up while he's watching TV, he would just, you know, lean out, clam.
Oh.
Okay.
I used to dance in front of the TV, and my dad would say, get out of the way. You're blocking the screen.
And a lot of people have said this, but we were the remote controls, you know, channel 7, jiggle the handle.
But that was my
move the rabbit ears. Yeah, exactly.
I would always be dancing and singing.
So that was it. See, that's way better now.
Oh,
you're
crystal
clear.
That's
much better.
That mic, something's going on with
something's
it.
Oh, wrong.
No. Yeah. We got to get the techs in here.
I feel so much better now.
Okay, I'm going to bring up one more thing. I don't know if this bothers anybody, but these days, we have a lot of breweries, like microbreweries,
uh-huh.
right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And now they're set up. People bring babies and little kids all the time to the breweries. And
right.
Some of them even have a children's section. Okay, I get it. We didn't have this when my kids...
Yeah, the mic is really good, Roy. We just heard his insides. That wasn't a spring. We didn't lose a spring or anything. Donna's like, you know, on the inside.
That was not out of my mouth. That just came from right here. I didn't mean it. Wasn't
never mind. Go, bud. Wow. You were on a roll, Donna.
This
go.
Is yeah.
Kids so section in microbrewery.
We didn't have this when my kids were little. Okay, yeah. I can understand that maybe sometimes you want to bring the kids. But the same thing as restaurants. I mean, technically, I would think that you should only have people 21 and over. But when you have little kids running around and screaming.
While you're trying to have a beer.
When you're trying to have a beer, for God's sake.
No, it's parents are afraid to be parents.
It's just a whole different thing these days, yeah.
And where I live, we're near a pool in our apartment. So it's the screaming and the hooping and the hollering. And I just, why do you have to scream at the pool? Why?
Because it's outside and
parents,
it's a pool.
And why aren't your parents going, hey, keep it down. People live here. Show some respect.
Yeah, no, nobody, when it's out there.
Have a good time.
Have some laughs, turn on the music, but blood curdling freaking screams, and you're 10 years old.
Yeah, they'll probably say, oh, we're outdoors. It's no, yeah. But I mean, right. I mean, a lot of parents don't pay any attention
parents
these
aren't,
days.
Aren't
they just
policing
don't.
This, and it's just disrespectful to everyone around.
Yeah,
and
we sound like Mr. Wilson, all of us.
Yeah, well, you know, and,
we sure
and
do.
People way younger than us are going to agree with us, but they won't do anything about it.
We're getting cranky and old is what they're going to say.
I'm accepting my place in life. The transformation is fine with me.
Well, I remember growing up, there was actually at the theater on when it used to be down there on Mission. Remember, it was a walk-in. That's where I saw like Star Wars, I think, the first time.
The Montclair Theater?
No, it was lower. That it was on Mission. It was way down there. And it was a big theater, I remember. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But they had a crying room in the back.
Perfect.
So they had the theater, and then in the back of the seating area, there was like a booth, like a big heavy room in there that you could take your kids in if they got out of it. So you could still watch the movie. Your kids could yell and scream in there, you know, if they were crying, having a problem, and then you didn't bother them.
I don't know if we had those in the theaters. I was thinking we had a crying room in church. There's always a crying room in church.
I had a crying room. It's called my bedroom.
Yeah.
Down to your room.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Number six, I think we could all agree with. I don't even know how far we have to go with this. Number six.
Huh.
Racists.
Oh, yeah.
That's easy.
Yeah.
That's easy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jump over that one.
Yeah, it's like there's nothing to talk about.
Yeah.
You know what? We got to go to break. This is one free comeback for you, Jimmy.
Okay.
Because we have right. Oh yeah, we are. This is in Jimmy's. So it'll be. We did the 10 to 6.
Yeah.
Now we got top five.
Top five. All right. When we come back, we got the top five.
Oh, I can hardly wait.
Oh my goodness, the suspense.
Dude,
oh,
this is gonna be so good.
The suspense
good.
Is gonna kill me. I gotta go do a calming walk around because I'll probably get all fired up. It's Ryan Jimmy in the morning. It's chaoticradio.com. Your chaotic radio time is 8:08. Get your butt going. You're probably late to work now. You switch mics, and now you look like you got a homemade operation going on.
Right, I know, but it's better.
It is better, yeah. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning. It's chaoticradio.com. Chaotic Radio time is 8:17.
Oh, wow.
Can you believe that? I think we should check on some weather and traffic first before we get back to our top five.
Yes.
All right, let's hit Donna Main up with a little weather.
Hey, let's look at Sedona, Arizona. It's beautiful, 73 degrees and sunny currently. The high today will be 89 in Sedona. Looks lovely. And New York. Oh, it's sunny, 77 degrees And the high today will be 84 in New York. Wow.
That's pretty decent
that
for New
York. That sounds pretty nice, actually. I don't know. Maybe it's time for a road trip.
Road trip.
San Francisco, California. 62 degrees right now and sunny. The high will be 68. Ooh, a little cooler up there. Cut and Shoot, Texas, once again. We love Cut and Shoot, Texas. It is now 87 degrees and sunny. The high today will be 93.
Nice.
And here we are. I'll just say one more time. Rancho Cucamonga, 60 degrees currently and cloudy. Did it feel like 60 degrees right now outside?
Meh.
No.
Feels
ugly.
High today, 83, though. It's going to warm up, guys.
Well,
all right.
Brace yourselves for that one there.
All right. Shorts and flip-flops. Okay.
Shorts and flip-flops. And we're going to fire up the Chaotic Radio Kudos Pizzeria Traffic Helicopter with... I'm going to steal this, Commander Roy.
55 southbound at Chapman. Backed up all the way up to Catella. Speeds are down to about 13 miles an hour. An accident. Right lane blocked. 10 freeway eastbound. Still the serious crash there at Monta Vista. You are still backing all the way up right around to the 57. And, of course, we've got Spectator slowing 10 freeway westbound. Same area. Speeds are down to 14 miles an hour. Everyone wants to see if someone lost their life.
Of course, I guess.
Naturally.
I guess so. 60 freeway westbound, right at the 15 interchange. Crashes now off to the right shoulder. Speeds are down to 28 miles an hour. Looks like it's back to around Etowanda Avenue. And 15 freeway southbound. Not bad. Just past the 210, speeds are down to about 41 miles an hour.
That sounds like fair.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fair.
Quit your whining.
71 south at Euclid, normal speed slowing 16 miles an hour all the way to the 91 split. And the 91 starts backing up at the 15. Slow and go, speeds are about 19 to 20 miles an hour all the way to the 71.
Double digits, that's not bad.
Yeah.
Not bad, you'll look at traffic there.
I have one question.
Go ahead.
One question, Roy. How does Mike Tyson say spectator slowing?
He said spectator slowing. And then when you sit there, God, I got Dennis again. It ludicrous. God, see, where did Mike go?
Keep going.
You know how you got to start with Mike? Huh. It's just moist. It's ludicrous at the moist on the freeway. There it is.
There you go.
You got to go moist.
You got to have your keyword to bring you back in.
Someone in our chat room said that there's just some grumpy old assholes on the air right now, but I've got to say something, and I'm going to tell you who it is. It's Matt. Okay, it's Commander Matt. He's down there running around.
And we all know how calm Matt is on any opinion he has.
Right, but here's the thing with Matt. And I'm going to tell you, because we were talking, we're going to go to the next one that's going to get Jimmy really fired up.
Yeah.
We're bracing ourselves.
We're working up to it.
But we were talking about screaming babies, and I think that's where he went in at.
Yeah.
And how parents don't have control. Matt, I'm going to say, and I'm not sucking up, Matt is a great dad.
We don't really know.
No, my view is he's a great dad. But when we were talking about that, I know for a fact... He wouldn't let his kids run around a freaking restaurant and raise hell and go crazy or screaming and yelling and bothering other people. So, Matt, get off my ass because I know you agree with us. I know you will do the dad stuff when you need to, but I also know you're the disciplinarian. God, I almost didn't get that one out. And so you're on board with this, so stop.
And we don't know how many tea parties he's had with Madison.
Oh, I know he would.
Yeah. Yeah, he's in the pink room. He's got the He's got the pink bonnet on. He's working the whole role.
But he's dropping an 805 in the cup though.
just a splash.
This is daddy's tea, honey.
Yeah, daddy's medicine right here.
That's freaking funny. All right, we're gonna go to number five.
Okay.
All right,
Jimmy's. This is Jimmy,
brace.
And we should probably play some Christmas music when I do this.
No.
But it doesn't. It's not a Christmas thing.
This could be my test here. I will not cuss.
Okay.
Okay.
You might have a hard time.
I know, but I'm gonna test myself right here.
Okay, ready?
I will not cuss.
Number five, things that piss you off. The most annoying things.
Hmm.
People. Already Jimmy's mad.
Yeah, people. You already had the opener right there. People
who walk really slow in front of you.
Oh, God.
I knew it was going to
Road rage.
Yes.
Especially in the mall when they're walking around like they've never been there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, is that a roof?
But here's the thing.
Is that an atrium?
And you should do it like, if you're in the mall and that's happening, you should do it like the freeway. Slow traffic, move right.
Move to the side.
Move to the side.
If yeah. you're going to go into a store, you got to merge. Merge in and out. It's the same thing, right?
Well, to me, it's a group, whether it be a family or bros or the gals out shopping, when there's four or five across.
Well, that's my favorite, in the parking lot. They're in the middle of the road in the parking lot and like five people across. Yeah. And they won't move.
And they don't walk straight across. They'll take the long parallel.
But
and even in the grocery store, it happens all the time.
Yeah.
Well, people will stop and talk right in the middle of the freaking aisle or walk real slow.
Put your cart to the side.
Move to the right.
Yeah.
Yep.
I barrel right through.
Stop right in front
of
you.
I knew this.
My dad had the best one.
Okay, do it.
I love my dad. My hero. Role model, mentor. We were at Walmart with my brother-in-law, and this is my brother-in-law's kind of first foray into a family outing. And I don't know how Walmart came about, but we all went to Claim Jumper.
I was going to say, Walmart sounds like a great family outing.
The women folk of the group to say, hey, let's go to Walmart, get some towels or whatever the hell they want to do. And us guys were like, all right. So we just moseyed in. And of course, us guys went to the stereo section, TVs, electronics, like, okay, just let us know when you're done. Just going through, my dad, he's walking through, and this family of nine, just taking up the whole aisle. Now, you know Walmart's got some pretty big main aisles.
Yeah, they
just stopped in the middle, and I don't know if they were just feeding their kids or whatever, catching up on the week, but right there in the middle, my dad with his cane come walking up, stops, squatted down to this lady and goes, excuse me, can you get the F out of my way? In that tone. And they were so stunned. It was like parting the Red Sea. It was a slow, no comment movement.
And he had a cane?
Yeah. And he just squatted down.
Wow.
Excuse me.
It's some people are just so oblivious.
Well, it kind of takes that to jar people into being good citizens.
Yeah.
When they go, oh, God, I am. They're not aware that they did that, which is already the problem. And we just followed him. We just trailed him through. And my brother-in-law was like, someone pressed, he goes, oh, my God, that was the most awesome thing I've ever seen. No fight, no yell. No one yelled.
Yeah.
Right. Had the calm tone.
Yeah.
And just, excuse
very
me.
Politely.
Yeah. And then, but then the opposite of my dad is, me and him go to, I don't grocery shop my dad anymore. Because he'll grab the can of peas, go to the box boy and go, what the hell is this? 79 cents? Kid didn't do anything. Dad.
Like the kid's making up the prices.
We're in the checkout aisle, and I've already coped with dad going through. And it's fun and not fun. The more out of town we are, I'll go to the store with him. Arizona, for example. But we're standing there, and the lady checker, she was buxom.
Yes, I was going to say well endowed.
Well endowed in his testicle area.
I saw your gestures.
She was a little. It's a testicle in a chesticle.
Chesticle area. And, she could have used a little more support.
Oh.
Okay. And my dad likes to say things under his breath, but it's not under his breath. Right. He thinks it is. So he's like, he's second. And I'm standing there.
Oh, God.
And he just lowers his head and he goes, Jesus Christ, I'll buy you the bra. I'm like, oh, Dad, give me the keys. I got to go warm the car up. And I just slinked right on out of there. Inside, I'm dying. It's the best thing. He's my hero.
He wanted to give her some support.
Exactly. Yeah, but down there, it's just like, Jesus Christ, I'll buy you a bra. Dad. That was great, but shush.
Yeah.
I did yell at an old man the other day.
Yeah?
Just a quick thing. Mm-hmm. So why don't you shut up? Was it?
Oh, that was kind of nothing.
Well, no, but what happened was
it just came to me. Yes. He couldn't hear you.
No.
Is that what it was?
Don was driving. Kylie got really sick. Went and picked up her prescription. We just talked about that.
Shut up.
And we pulled up in front of Tony says it's cloudy in 63 in Shank and Stab OC. So
Tony Storm.
Right, it's Tony Storm. So we pull up in front of the Mills. You know that little part of the Mills where it has the cutout where you can pull in and it's like red loading, unloading.
Yeah.
Okay, right in front of the Improv and all that. So we pull up, and they have the wheelchair access area in that spot that goes into the crosswalk. So Don's driving, and I'm sitting in the passenger seat, and we pull up, and we're kind of slowly looking at Kylie working over there to see if we can find her so we can take her meds.
Right.
So we're pulling up, and we pull into that little area. And we're, like, rolling, like, half a mile an hour looking to see if we can see her.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Now, we see two old guys pushing this old lady, older, probably 70s, with her leg out, and they're pushing her in a wheelchair.
Uh-huh.
And as we're pulling up, I say something to Don. I go, "We're in that intersection." She goes, "I know. We're, you know, we're still rolling. I'm just looking. I just want to make sure she knew."
Right.
So as we're going, they start yelling at us from like 15 yards away.
What?
Get out of the way! What are you doing? And we're like, and Don's like, "I know. We're looking for someone. I'm not stopping." And the all of them are bitching out loud because we're blocking their thing, and we're not. They can't even get to us in time. It's not like we stopped, got out of the car. We're rolling slowly in the loading, unloading zone. I mean, still rolling. And she goes, "I know, I see it. I'm moving." And the guy's like, "Why don't you just pull in front of it?" And I go, "Why don't you just shut up?" I was like, it's like they couldn't, if they ran, they couldn't have got to us by the time we were out of the section.
Right.
Yeah.
It lit me up.
They're still a half mile away.
Oh, piss me off. Sorry. I pulled a Jimmy right there.
Yelling at old people. Roy.
That is funny.
Do that in the safety of your car with the windows up.
The window was down, man.
The window was down.
Oh, no.
Bro.
Number four is great.
The window was down, bro. That's how I roll.
Number four.
Right. Number four.
Number four.
Number four.
Bullies.
Bullies.
Well, I just yelling at an old person, and all of a sudden, I'm bullies.
Well, you have to define bully. Now, these are a lot of things. So you say racist, you say bullies, you say there are degrees.
That can cover.
There are degrees that people will automatically say that's bullying. Mm-hmm. So if you look back, if we look back on my little dork life,
Yeah.
I was probably two steps away from being Sheldon Cooper.
Yeah.
I had the sweater vest, horn rimmed glasses. I got picked on.
Really?
But I was a little dude. And, you know, you kind of go, well, that's kind of my place right now. It's going to happen. Like Ariana was talking about dodgeball. And back in the day, they called it what? Smear the Queer?
Yeah.
And,
oh, yeah.
And she goes, "Man, you remember that game?" I go, "I was the queer. I'm the one who got smeared. It was just the way." And she's like, "Oh." And people don't realize I wasn't this size constantly.
Right.
Yeah.
Were you
short at one time?
Yeah. I was short. All my friends in grade school, up and probably like junior high, I was probably 1 or 2 shorter.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. Well, yeah. Boys grow later usually. But,
right.
Yeah.
And that was just the way it is. I was that guy.
Yeah.
And I got no problem with it. It was part of growing up.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I'm the one who got slugged in the chest because, "You ever make my friend Chester?" "No." "Boom. You just did." "Oh, thank you. He's a nice guy." And then you walk home.
Yeah.
It's just the way it happens. I don't like people being constantly picked on. I have empathy. And I think that's what's missing out of a lot of these terms right now between the Me Too, the bullying, and all that.
Oh, yeah.
There's sympathy, but there's not empathy.
Right.
You know, I don't know what you're going through, but I feel for you.
I think we all got bullied to some extent.
To some degree, something happened. Yeah. Absolutely. But bullying,
I think it was part of, and I don't mean over and over again, you made the point. But I think that part of being bullied and having that interaction and maybe getting in a fight or maybe doing all that is part of growing up, makes you who you are today.
And sometimes you're on one end or the other.
Right,
either you're the bully or you're the one getting picked on.
Right.
Yeah,
and, of
course,
obviously it wasn't too out of control where you have to take care of it. But, you know, you just accept that's
what
happened.
Most of the stuff we did was stupid.
If I could have hit someone back, absolutely. But I couldn't. They're usually bigger than me, and they had the confidence I couldn't carry.
Yeah.
You got to have a lot of confidence to be a bully in grade school back then.
Yeah.
But now everybody just kind of goes.
So, like, and here's what I mean. It's like it shapes us who we are today. Again, not everyone needs to get bullied, but you're going to get bullied. You're going to get pushed around. You're going to fight back. You're going to do that. It makes you stand up, gives you some, even if you fight back and you lose, then all of a sudden you notice usually bullying stops.
Well, this will get Ryan and Matt fired up. Not everyone's a winner.
Right.
Not everyone, you know, and if I tell my dad, I got hit today. He goes, "Did you hit him back?" "No." "Well, what was your problem?"
Yeah.
Right. Fight back.
So you kind of let that happen to yourself. You know, and he wasn't trying to say, you know, go get the car jack and beat shit out of him. He's like, you know, shove back.
So, you know? And here's the thing where I think it's over the top. One of the comments on this, there's comments on all these. I think this one. "They ruined middle school for me. I can't even look at that building without having bad memories rushing back to me. They ruined people's lives for literally no reasons besides they're bored and jealous." Now, hold on a minute. First of all, they're not jealous of you if they're picking on you, usually. And they ruined middle school, and he can't even look at a building now. Suck it up.
It's not like all these awful things that have been happening recently.
I agree.
Yeah, our stuff was pretty frivolous, really. You know,
and,
small,
and a lot of the frivolous
things.
Right, yeah. Now is becoming, yeah, the major,
yeah,
thing.
Yeah, yeah. No,
and
it was.
So you can't even address the situation without the extremes going on.
Right.
And
right.
That is actually a big problem, yeah, there. But like I said, not everyone's a winner. And even the winners got their asses kicked a few times.
Right. Yeah.
I think everyone throws that meme around how Michael Jordan sucked.
Yeah.
Got denied. You know, and all these people got denied until one day they weren't.
Yeah,
and that's part of life. But
yeah,
you got to let people have a life too. But part of life is getting your ass kicked.
You have to. Yeah, you get knocked down. You got to learn to get back up.
Exactly, in your own way.
Right.
Rocky said it best. It's not many times you get knocked down, you get it back up again.
I didn't start this. You started this. I didn't start this. John Rambo.
Yeah. All right. I agree with that.
All right, number...
Number three.
Number three.
This one's kind of funny.
Oh, we need a little break.
Do we need a break?
No.
Oh,
we need a...
Something...
Okay. Social...
A light, more lighthearted...
Number three?
Annoying thing?
I can't believe it made the top 10.
Huh.
Number three is straight up Justin Bieber.
Really? Oh, my goodness.
Is that the greatest? We got these things that are doing all this and that. Justin Bieber.
Brace yourself, Matt. What the hell?
I didn't know that was such a universal annoyance. That's funny.
He's annoying, I guess, because everybody put him so up there immediately that he was bound to fail.
There are probably other celebrities that are in that same category.
He was just a brat kid on the plane. They just wouldn't shut him up.
Yeah.
And gave him everything. And then he turns out this, and then everyone turns on him. It's like, no, you guys did this to him.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you made him a
dick. You made him popular. You made him who he is.
He was a little five-year-old singing. They're like, this guy, we're going to make a shit ton of money off him. Not that he's a musical genius. He's not Stevie Wonder when he was little. No. Yeah.
Back on the kids one, Matt did chime in. He said, ha ha, I would put down the SmackDown if the kids were running around. But he has no problem with the kids in breweries.
So no problem with kids inside the brewery.
It's just if they're running around screaming.
See, there you go.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, because obviously I love kids. I love babies. And babies are going to cry. Babies are going to scream. You can't, you know, the only thing you can do is maybe take them outside if it's something like a movie going on.
I'll go with Matt's thing here. I have no problem with kids in a bar or a brewery now.
Uh-huh.
But when it was getting to be more and more, I was just like, you know, holy shit, is that a kid in here? What's a kid doing in here?
We always joke around and say, oh, it's kids' day at the brewery.
There's your designated driver right there.
Kids' night. and maybe, I don't know, maybe when they're little, it's not a big deal, but maybe when they get to be, like, preteen, I don't know, is it the best environment? If everybody's just there to drink, I don't know.
Daddy needed some medicine.
That's a whole different...
I think it's good to take them, because normally the kids are the reason you drink.
Well,
this is what you're doing to me.
What you're doing
I'm just pissed
to
off right because they didn't have that when my kids were little.
Now it comes out.
Well, our parents didn't have those kind of bars. We had bars.
Yeah.
Two dark doors, and there's
no way you can take a kid into a bar.
Two dark doors and no windows. Yeah, those were the bars and breweries we had back in the day. You sit right here and see what you've done to Daddy.
Right.
All right, so Bieber.
All right, here we go. Here's the one that's going to throw to the top. My list went away. I clicked the thing, but I saw number one, so I don't know what two
are
was.
We at number... Number two.
No, I lost it.
Oh, gotcha.
But I know what number one was.
We lost our number two.
We lost our number two. Scared of a...
Damn cornhole.
Number one?
Yeah.
Damn. I can't get it back. Anyway, I know what it was because I looked at it. Number one, and I'll agree, mosquitoes.
Oh, wow.
I hate mosquitoes.
The list we just went through.
Well, it says annoying.
Yeah.
They're annoyance.
These are really...
you know, I think flies would actually top mosquitoes.
I say mosquitoes, though, because mosquitoes do more damage.
They
carry diseases that...
But most of the time we see mosquitoes are actually mosquito eaters. The big ones.
Oh, well, yeah. Well, you don't always see the mosquitoes. That's the problem.
I'm going to vote fly. And I'm going to vote one fly. There's always one fly.
Fly
come by?
Okay.
No, I'm not on board on that one. Mosquito, that was a letdown.
I'm annoyed by mosquitoes because if I'm outside in the evening in the summertime, they always find me.
I am annoyed after the mosquitoes bite me.
They are, they carry a few diseases now, which is not good. I know people that have gotten West Nile and things like that. Oh. So it's not good. But, yeah, I wouldn't make them number one.
No,
but,
it's a letdown.
But this is a very diverse list. Let's put it that way.
It was very diverse.
Trying to get back to the list, yeah. I clicked on one that I would probably do the top six on because we don't have a lot of time, but it's pretty good. And someone in my household would be pretty angry at number two.
We can do six after the break.
Yeah, we'll do six.
Yeah. Okay. I got a quick shout out to one of our listeners, Lisa Woodward, one of our boot camp buddies from back in the day.
Hey!
Tuned in and says, hey, good morning. So back at you, Lisa.
Nice.
I like old friends.
Ari, Roy didn't protect you back in school? How sad.
No. I protected him.
Uh-huh. No, maybe a little bit.
You went on the trip.
Yeah, no. But, I mean, you were like with, you know, Larry and me, and we kind of...
Yeah,
we picked on more than anyone was Darren Acosta.
Yeah, he was a dork.
He was a dork.
Yeah.
When a dork tells you you're a dork, you're a dork.
When I say it, it's got some weight to it.
Because Jimmy was still cool.
I had moments.
Yeah.
I had moments. I can blend.
Yeah. But that was like fifth grade, and then when you went to sixth grade, you started to turn that cool thing in.
Yeah, and really you knew
you
where you're at. You knew where you're at in junior high. You're either cool or you're dork. And there was no picking on it. No one had to tell you that.
Yeah.
Grade school, though. They're letting you know, hey, dude, it don't look good.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It don't look good for you, some of the queer.
Can't do it anymore.
They pick last in all the sports. Kickball, shirts and skins. Shirt. I'll be a shirt. I'm a shirt. I'm definitely a shirt.
I was a fat kid. I want to be a shirt, too.
I'm a shirt. Dodgeball, all that. All right, we'll take Jimmy. That was me at the end. All right, we'll take him. He's standing there. Someone's got to get him. Someone should take this guy. Poor bastard. He's just sitting there. We'll take our last break where he's got a...
We'll do top... Only reason I'm going to do top six is because six will piss some people off. But number two, Kylie would lose her mind.
Oh, that's... Wow. I love people losing their mind.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, we're losing them. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning. It is chaoticradio.com. Chaotic Radio time is 8:39 a.m. You're way late or almost there.
Already.
Little Roy and Jimmy in the morning. We're at Grand Funk Railroad.
GFR.
Oh, yeah.
See, the one thing I loved about the 70s, the music, but the names of the bands.
Right.
Grand Funk Railroad. Beckman Turner Overdrive. Edison Lighthouse.
Yeah.
Just neat shit like that. I love that. Oh, look at that. I failed my cussing test.
Oh.
Yeah, but it wasn't on the subject you thought about.
Oh, see, right, I did. Right. Did I not behave?
Yes, you did.
No, you did.
It didn't get you wound up.
You did well.
It didn't get you wound up.
I was wound up, but I kept it in check.
I thought you'd be more
fired. You did a good job.
I kept it in check.
You did a good job.
Okay, we're winding down our Tuesday morning right here at chaoticradio.com. Little Roy and Jimmy in the morning with Donna Main.
It's going so fast.
Yeah, we can do this quick.
And Roy says he's got a top six.
Yeah.
Because we can't do all the top ten.
So you customized it.
Well, I could jump down to one of them. It's top 10 bands that are killing rock.
We already kind of went off on that, so let's hear it.
We'll just jump to number 9, honorable mention, Fall Out Boy.
Not familiar.
All right,
here we go.
It's not. They're not a boy band, so I think it's okay.
All right, here we go. Number 6, people are going to be pissed, Maroon 5.
That's killing rock?
Killing rock.
Huh? I don't think Maroon 5 is rock. I think they're pop.
It's more pop.
I got no problem with Adam and the boys.
Yeah.
All right, number 5, everyone beats him up all the time, and I still like to listen to him.
Nickelback.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe because they started out with such a bang, and then it's just people expected so much. But, they do get a bad rap because, you know, it's not bad.
All right. Number 4, Mumford & Sons.
I'm not familiar. I've heard a couple of tunes, but I do enjoy that they're not poppy.
Well, the original Mumford & Sons, they were that folky Dust Bowl kind of music, and I loved some of their songs. Really, yes, I like them. And then I know they came out a while later with an album where they tried to go more pop and mainstream, and that wasn't working for me.
Backfired.
But, and I'm not, I don't like country music, but I like some of that folky stuff. And that, I thought they, when they did that, they were like the first ones to have that sound, really. They were, they, you know, there are more bands now that I think are imitating their sound. Original sound.
Okay.
But I thought they were very cool and original. I
so,
like them.
One of the yeah. quotes says, these guys make mm-hmm. folk rock look like a joke. Their overuse of the word heart is so annoying, it makes you wish you never heard the word again for the rest of your life. Their lyrics are incredible cheesy as well.
Oh, wow. Ooh, boy, wow.
Not happy. Not
That's
a fan.
That's painful.
Not a fan.
All right, number three.
Yes.
Coldplay.
Oh, yes. Oh man, that hurts that is, me.
Does it?
You know what? I love...
You can dawn on this one.
You're killing her.
The old Coldplay, original Coldplay stuff. The old stuff is amazing.
Because it was new and it was fresh,
oh,
right?
Oh, but they... Well, because they've changed... Once again...
They tailored.
They've changed over the years, and some would say they've sold out, you know.
Sure.
They do... They are more poppy now, and...
I never was a fan, so...
I like the old stuff. I really do. One of the current songs, I like. It's catchy. But I really like the old stuff. So, once again, it's... Yeah, they've changed over time.
Quit picking on Donna. Right.
All right. All right. Go ahead.
All right. This is the one that would light up Kylie.
Number
two.
Go.
21 Pilots.
Oh.
Not familiar.
I know.
She is a 21 Pilot freak.
Yeah.
All right. Let me see.
I've heard some of their songs. Yeah.
Let me get
there's probably one or two that I.
It says literally any 21 Pilot song is about depression or love. They even covered a song about themselves.
A little heady.
Most songs are about depression or love, pretty much. I mean, look at country music.
hey, easy on the country music.
This is true. I have no. I got no reference of what even to play.
Here, I'll pull one up that's pretty popular.
Yeah, yeah.
A Stressed Out is one. You've heard that one.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm sure I have.
Yeah, you've heard Stressed Out.
Yeah.
Yeah, throw a few bars out there.
Yeah, go ahead.
I can't because my shit didn't work.
Oh, here, I'll get it.
Oh, man, his shit doesn't work again.
Damn, Roy.
Too much cornhole. Kind of hurts.
You're stiff in the wrong places again.
Mm-hmm.
What's the name of the song?
Stressed out. Stressed Out.
Stressed Out. All right, let's do it. And I'll even pull up the one with the lyrics. All right, let's see. Okay. 21 Pilots, Stressed Out.
You've heard it.
Let's see if there's an ad. Oh, yeah, of course there's an ad.
Yeah, because they're popular.
Yeah.
That's one of the annoying things is everything has an ad now.
Mm.
Even when you watch a Facebook
video. Was advertising. It was
when
there.
You have a Facebook video.
I wish I found some better sounds no one's ever heard. I wish I had a better voice and sang some better words. I wish I found some chords in an order that is new. I wish I didn't have
bad.
To
rhyme.
No, wait, you get to the cook
yeah,
part.
Yeah, you gotta hear it. You gotta hear it.
My fears would shrink, but now I'm insecure and I care what people think. My name's Blurry Face and I care what you think. My name's
Blurry farther.
Face and I care what you think. Wish we could turn back time.
You've heard this.
Yeah,
see, you got
out.
The hook. You knew what it was.
Yeah, now I'm out.
Yeah.
And number one is, I don't care, is Imagine Dragons.
Oh, they are so freaking popular.
Yeah, yeah. Ariana likes them, and I'm just but like, it just sounds, they, it could have been this
pretty,
song.
They, yeah, I would say Imagine Dragons and 21 Pilots kind of sound alike, don't you think?
Yeah.
That actually took me there. What's the one that they have with Thunder? And there's the one everyone knows.
I don't know. Couldn't even tell
like,
you.
Like the current big hit, or like one of their first big hits was that Radioactive song, right?
I have no idea.
I think so.
I don't know shit about these people, except I know it's annoying.
We're sounding very old today.
Matt. Damn it, Matt.
What do you say?
Let's hear.
No, I
was uptight.
This one.
Wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave.
It sounds similar to the one we just listened to.
Yeah, they do sound very similar.
Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer. Take a number. I was lightning.
A lot of like.
Oh, these poor guys. All the angst. Okay. The angst they're going through.
That theme song from Oh my God. What was the... Oh, God, I just blanked out. I'm so sorry.
We are being old today.
That song took the thing and the one thing they did.
I think it...
Yeah, I just...
Yeah.
It sounds, I think it was, just like we listened to. Yeah, that's tune out.
They do... Those two bands sound very similar.
I don't believe their lyrics. These young puppies talking about angst and...
Well, they talk about what it... Yeah. The good old days. Yeah, they talk about the good old days. And
you missed me at 15. Yeah. Is 19 that hard for
That's me. Like a 15-year-old or a 17-year-old telling you, back in the day.
I can't even.
Did 21 Pilots do that song, Heathens?
Yeah.
All My Friends Are Heathens?
Yeah, I did see that in the list, yes.
Okay, I kind of... And that was the theme song from that movie.
Yeah, it was a theme song, that's
and
right.
And I kind of like that song, I gotta admit.
Yeah, I'm not going to say...
It was from Suicide Squad.
Suicide Squad, yeah, that's what I was trying to
say.
Yeah.
I hate everything, because there'll be a couple things I'll hear
that
and I'll
song
go,
grew on me.
Yeah, I'm like, okay, that's not bad, but then at the same time, I'm like, I really don't care.
But it sounds very much like all their other songs.
Angst.
Yeah,
oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
But I kind of like that, All My Friends Are Heathens.
All My Friends Are Heathens. I'm going to put on my...
But it was, you know, because it was the ambiance of the movie, you know what I mean? That was
I'm gonna put on my knit cap and go now.
Yeah.
call me an Uber. I'm having a tough day.
Yeah. I lost one of my earplugs.
Oh, my beard is... I have no beard wax. Oh no. Oh no. Jeez, you poor guys, you poor bad. Try being the queer and smear the queer. Then sing me a song.
Yeah.
Bastards.
This is like Mr. Wilson.
There we go, Mr.
Wilson. Try working for 40 years.
Give that a go. Get off my lawn. Yeah. All right, this has been Roy and Jimmy in the Morning for this week. And next time we're going to see you will be next Monday. It will be the month of June.
It'll be June.
What? So, Roy Brewster, Donna Main, I am Jimmy Shaw. This has been Roy and Jimmy in the Morning, chaoticradio.com. Tonight, 8 o'clock, a best of Roy and Jimmy thing. 8 to 10 right here, chaoticradio.com. You guys have a great week. We will talk to you on Monday tomorrow morning. Jeff Sargent and the Beast from the East, Pat Jankowicz.
Wow, that was nice.
Yeah.
You guys all have an awesome week. We'll talk to you next week. Love you all. Hit them, baby.
Love you. Bye.
You do.